Okay, so I can write right now. All right, so let's take a look. Yeah. So Simon had $10.90 more than Gerald. Every day, Simon spent $3, Gerald spent $2.40. When Simon spent all his money, Gerald still had $2.90 left. How many days did Simon take to spend all his money?
What?
let's just take a look, okay? So what we can do is Simon had $10, it's 2%, okay? Huh? No, this can erase already. So Simon, can you see red color? $10.90 more than Gerald. So, J, this is Gerald, okay? So, well, I use a mouse. Right, $10.90 more than Gerald. So $10.
I thought you
have
to use your pencil.
Yeah, I know. Wait, huh?
Why do you not use your pencil?
I will. Okay, $10.90. Can you see that? Good. So every day, Simon. Yeah, it's $10.90. See? It is $10.90. Yeah, 90 cents. Oh, looks like 90 cents. It's a one here, okay. So every day, Simon spent $3. Gerald spent $2.40. When Simon spent all his money, Gerald still had $2.90 left. Now this is a difficult question. Can you help her print the worksheet for her? Yeah, she did not bring her. Okay, so Simon had $10. So now the fastest way to do this, right, is if you were to do guess and check. Okay, yes. Right, the fastest way to do this question is just guess and check.
We don't have time to do guess and check.
I know, but it's the fastest way. What do you mean by?
Can't you just assume?
Assume what? What
do you mean? Guess and check, yeah.
You did for an hour.
Huh? Yeah.
Okay.
I took 7 minutes.
7 minutes, how to do 7 minutes? Okay, wait, so every day Simon spent three. Every day, Simon spent $3, Gerald spent $2.40.
Question, why are they making the exam so hard?
I don't know. When Simon spent all his money, so Simon spent all, which is 60 cents. So the difference is 60 cents. Gerald had $2.90 left. Okay, so I'll use another color. Yeah. $2.90 left. Okay, here, Gerald, this one, right, is 2.4. Because every day spend $2.40, right, times the number of days.
I'm really confused.
What? Can you see that? You see here, every day spend $2.40. Ten, let's say the days is 10.
I really gave up.
One more time. If wait. If every day spend $2.40, let's say it's only one day.
Then 2.40.
This will be 2.40. But we don't know how many days, huh? Yeah, you know what I mean? No, this is 2.40 and I don't know, it could be 10 days, 20 days, 30 days. I don't know. Okay. Wait, so how about Simon? Simon spent $3 every day. So $3 every day. So this whole thing, the whole thing, right, is actually $3. Okay, this one right here. This is $3 times the number of days.
I thought you were about to see the entire amount of $3.
No, the whole thing is $3 times the number of days. Okay, so what this means is, if I take $3 times the number of days, or you can call it like...
Can't you just find like a denominator?
Well, there's no fraction denominator here. Oh. If I take this whole
then
thing...
Algebra.
Yeah, if I take this whole thing...
Using everything to solve algebra.
Stop using algebra to solve everything. If I take this... Wait. If I minus this whole thing...
That you can't solve everything with algebra, then she's like, if you don't want to follow my way, then like,
What?
But I can't help you.
Okay, wait first. Let me try to solve this first, right? If I take three, okay, you see this whole thing is three times the number of days. Okay, question mark this. This whole thing is 2.4 times the number of days plus $2.90. What do you mean who's supposed to know?
How are you supposed to solve this?
We find the difference. What's the difference between the blue color one? You see the blue color? This is three times the number of days. Huh? No.
What?
The whole thing. What's the whole thing? The whole thing here is $3 times the number of days. If there are 10 days, right? This will be $30. Okay?
So
and then
10,
this will be like
30.
Yeah, so if what's the difference between this blue color thing and this whole blue color thing?
They're the same.
Wait, if I take this minus this equals to this, right? Okay, you see this picture a bit hard for me to draw. If I take 3 days minus $10.90. Oh, I can't see yet. Take away, or I can call it 10 units, right? Oh, sorry, 3 units. Minus $10.90. Because the whole thing is 3 units, right? If I minus this, $10.90 is the same as 2.4 unit plus 4U plus 2.90. Ooh. Okay, so what is the difference in the units? 0.6, right? So 0.6U is equal to here is 13. No. This one is $13.80. Calculator time. Units.
Wait,
10.9 plus 2.9. Hey, wait.
Why? $2.90.
Alright, because this is 3 units.
How is it more is 3 units?
Yeah, I wrote here. 3 times the number of days. So this whole thing is like 3 units. Then this one is 2.4 units plus $2.90.
So this is 1 unit.
Ah, yes. Wait, let me check.
They should have given like the total amount they had. That would be so cool.
You know what?
Why must we have exams?
Wait, so 1 unit equals to 23. Okay?
23.
Yeah, so days is 23. So you can check, okay? So if it's 23 days, it's 2.4 times 23 plus 2.9. This is $58.10. Okay, and 3 times 23, $69 minus $10.90. This is $58.10, right? So that's correct. So the number of days is just 23. Okay? Fastest way to solve? Wait. Yeah. This one?
58.1.
Wait, this is the fastest way. But is it the most, is it the easiest and the first thing that comes to your mind? No. Maybe yes. Maybe no. Okay? So how did I come up with this? Because I've done a lot. No. I don't have a big brain, my brain is small. Because I've done a lot.
Because your teacher.
Not all teachers know how to solve, okay? But I've done a lot of this.
Teacher, teacher Listen.
No, okay. There are some questions that I also don't know how to do, okay? Like online, I'll be like, sorry, I don't know how to do, right? Give me like 2 days and we can think about it, okay? It's fine. So how can I know how to solve now? It's because I've seen it before, and this is the fastest way. Now, the fastest way may not be your way, you understand? You can do it in another way, okay? But if you want to do it the fastest way, this will be the fastest way. It's just changing into units, that's all.
There was this one question
yeah.
And it was like,
So,
X, the
wait. Question, discussion later, right? So if you want to discuss question, it's fine, but you got to give us the full question like this. Then I can, then we can all discuss. Never mind, right? You can try to take a picture sometime, okay? So once we have answered this, we can already answer the part two, part B. How much money do they have altogether? This is $58.10, this is $69. So it's just 69 plus 58.10. All right, so my answer is 69 plus 58.10, $127.10. So you're right, you know, when you say that if you were to use guess and check, right, it's going to be tough because of the 10 cents. Okay, this question, if you were to use guess and check, that's like 10 cents, okay? It's going to be tough. And then also another reason why this question is going to be tough if you use guess and check is because the number of days is not 1 or 2, it's 23. Got it? So it's a big number. It'd be like 10 days, guess 10 days, 20 days, 30 days, 40 days. All right? It will probably take a long time. Okay? All right? So anyway, this is for her, Jobelle. This question, hope you go back, you try and see whether you can understand this, right? If you don't understand, I'll try to explain a bit more, okay? So once again, welcome any questions you have. Okay, have you taken a picture or copied down? Because I need to clear this really. Okay? Right, it's clear.
Do you take like the photo of
Jobelle's
paper?
Yeah, this is her paper. She has this question. She don't know how to solve. Okay, so yeah, just send to us. You can send to the receptionist. WhatsApp,
Instagram.
Instagram.
Oh.
TikTok.
I
love
TikTok.
YouTube.
You guys have TikTok?
I don't have a YouTube account.
You guys send messages.
Facebook. I mean, that's how students send me, okay? Always send me. They just send.
Does students send you by TikTok?
Yeah, there's TikTok, okay?
What's your TikTok account? Let me search it. What's it?
It's no, it's not Express. Okay, you go and find Instagram. It's linked to my Instagram. Chen Ting. ERNTENG. Okay? CHERNTENG.
Wait, I
want to
find you.
Yeah, just gonna add all my students are there.
Chen Ting.
Yes.
Chen Ting.
Okay. C H.
Mr. Ting.
ERNTENG.
Isn't this you?
Where?
This guy.
Yeah, that's me. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, Jobelle knows because it's his brother. I talk to his brother all the time. Her brother all the time. Okay, enough.
Humanizing
academic. It's not linked to what? Okay, done, huh? Clear this, right? I don't know where it is. Let's go to this now.
It sends me to your YouTube.
What YouTube? Go and try and link. You don't have to go to TikTok already, right? From there, you can just send the question, you understand?
Bro, I went to the video.
More on Instagram.
I went on the video, and this is what I found.
Where's my...
This is what you find on the video. Speed. Yeah, I'm gonna find this first.
Okay, so you all have the worksheet, right? We're gonna do this now. Now let me just do a recap before we start to do the speed question. Hey, at all. Look at the worksheet, okay? Okay, so speed chapter. Have you all done speed already at school?
Not
yet.
It's still like,
all right.
What
topic is it?
Like not ratio type of thing.
Oh, still ratio. Okay.
The table.
Can understand.
Oh my god, I changed.
Okay, so that's heuristic. Heuristic, we will come to heuristic soon, okay, under ratio. So for speed questions, there are three alphabets. Okay, what are the three alphabets? You know? Anyone? Yeah?
Distance.
D. S.
T.
Okay, what does D stand for?
Distance.
S is speed. This one is time. So if I want to find... if I want to find distance, what do I do?
Speed times time.
If I want to find speed, what do I do?
D times T.
Oh?
Divide.
Which one divided by what?
D divided by
T. Yeah, D divided by T, right? If I want to find time?
D divided by S.
Okay, this thing, are you clear? You know how it works?
No.
But you just said everything,
right?
You're just guessing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like I do so well, like the worksheets, but then when you do practice paper, I'm
reminded. So maybe just careless mistakes, right? So D equals S times T. S equals to D over T, and T is equal to D over S. Okay? So this is what you need to know, right? Before you can start to do the question. Yeah, copy this first.
I cried in class.
I didn't what? Cry? I literally cried.
It was so hard. My teacher making it super hard. She's making it like 10 questions. She's marking those 10 questions without finishing the paper. When I like, no, it's not fair.
Okay. You know why it's okay? Because it's still not the PSLE exam.
Yeah,
no,
but it's annoying because she always like, do the first 5 questions.
The school I think I'm going, right, is SGC.
Okay.
I don't have my hopes up to get into
NGS. Okay, finish. Okay. Ethel, this one finish already?
I'm not
Ethel. 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 Then what?
Ethel.
Ethel.
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay. You're done.
Yes.
Not Ethel. Ethel. How to pronounce?
Ethel.
Ethel, okay. Ethel. Okay, so you see, we have done all of this and homework. You see, homework do all. That was the last week stuff.
I just
but I know because you're Chinese New Year, right? Everyone just remember. Hey, wait, why didn't we do this?
Yeah, we have a lot of
work,
especially for science.
Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. So now what we're going to do is I need to go through all of this, okay? So let me go through all, because today we should finish this. And I actually hope to do circles.
No, can we
do
practice
papers,
please?
Wait. 3 days. Okay, we do practice papers.
Exam is in 1 week.
Okay. All right, so let's take a look at this, right? So ratio is tested, right? Your practice papers.
Okay, everything.
For my school, they're testing whole numbers, fractions, ratio, decimal, percentage, area of triangles, geometry.
Yeah.
Geometry,
okay, basically.
Wow. Wait, geometry?
Okay, basically, it's everything.
Yeah.
Can I
ask the
Okay, wait. Okay, wait first. Okay, hello, y'all. This cluster here, okay? Can we just focus on this one now? Okay, put away your phone. Right, let's look at question 25.
Yeah,
this is ratio. Yeah, we can do practice with it later. Okay, so look at question 25. Now, the ratio of Mei Hua storybook to Hui Hui is 5 is to 2. So, Mei Hua is to Hui Hui. Yeah, what a name, right? So, if Mei Hua's storybook is increased by 20%, now if you increase 5 by 20%, what will it become? It becomes 6. Why? Because 20% of 5 is 6. 20 over 100 times $5. Let's say $5 equals to 1. 20% of 5 is 1. So you plus 1 becomes 6.
Yeah.
It's because I've done all this so many times. Like, look at this, it's like half my eyes is closed. Okay. Come on, let's go. Huh? What? Wait. So their total will now become 192. So Hui Hui, did anything happen to Hui Hui? No. So still 2. Then the total.
Eight units.
Yeah. So 8 units is 192. So 1 unit equals to
24.
So what do we want? Meihua has 5. So 24 times 5. 1, 2, 0. Done. See, no, don't have working, right? Just ratio stuff, okay? I like to do ratio stuff. It's pretty easy. Ken?
I didn't need too many equations for 26.
Wait, I thought we're done already, 26.
You like
doing
stuff.
Oh, I give you all the clue, is it?
Yeah.
Like that, that's my clue.
Yeah.
What is this?
So because I asked you like, how to do 1 hour,
then. Oh, okay. Let's take a look at 26 now.
I already gave up. I lost all three.
I answered 168.
Okay, do first. Wait.
I want to ask someone for the what is
this? At all.
Okay.
Yeah, we do work now, okay? Okay, the distance between S and K is. Let me start from scratch. So the distance between S and K is 320. So I have S here, K here. Now Mr. Wu took 3 hours to cover the first part of the distance. So we have a first part, DST. I do not know the D, but I know he took 3 hours at 74. So the S is 74 times the time, D, speed times time, what do I get? Distance. So what's the distance? 74 times 3? 2, is it? Wow, 222. So 222 kilometers. Next one. He took another 1 hour 10 minutes to cover the remaining part. So time, 1 and 1 over 6 hours. Right, that's the T. Now, because the whole journey is 222, right? The whole journey is 320. Here is 222. So what's the remaining? 98. Wow, y'all calculate so fast. Oh.
No, John. Me and you have small brain.
Okay, so here's 98. Now you see you have distance, you have time. Can you find the speed?
Yes.
How to find speed? This divided by this, right? So
yeah.
98 divided by 1 and 1 over 6. 84. Wait.
I messed up. How is it so perfect?
Wait, how is it so perfect?
94
divided by 7.
I thought there
will
be a
14
times
6
because
it's
24. Divide by what again?
Divided by 7.
Why 7? Oh, I know what you did. Fraction. You did fraction, all right?
In purple.
In minutes. That's fine.
Yeah, she took 1 times 6.
Wait, what's the
reward? No, it's okay. She has her another way. It's fine. Get around 84. Easy or not? Wow, that's 30 seconds. Hello. 30 seconds.
I'm confused. I messed up.
Which part are you confused?
Why?
I messed up.
How do you get?
DST. DST. Okay. Everything is the
right. I knew that.
ST. DST. DST.
I think of DST. Then like, what?
GST, did you say GST?
It's mostly all about
DST. DST and percentage.
Can we change topic?
No.
The circle is different.
Next.
But this paper is the best, but we don't test DST yet.
Why not?
Okay, I need to get them to print the practice paper.
You wear shoes.
Why
do you
have so much
shoes?
Because I do a lot of things and shoes.
Are you like America and then they wear shoes in their house?
No,
I
alright, next. Okay, we are printing the worksheet now. Okay, so let's finish this. Huh? No, it's okay. Come. Okay, Mr. Shin travel average speed of 65. So this is our speed. And then this is the time. And then this is speed again. And this is the time. So what's the total distance? So I want to find the D. Right? How to find D? This times this. Okay. You must change the 24 to. So 65 times 24 over 60. Because we need to change the hour. See, the more you do, the better you get, right?
No, just
26 kilometers.
I'm very bad at speed, and my mom's like, just wait for Mr. Sandwich.
I don't like my school teacher that much.
Oh, she's my favorite teacher. I don't like
I wish my form teacher was my
best. I don't like my science teacher. Yeah, she's so terrible. She like chases her homework. Then she said this. Don't owe me homework, right, during this period. Then she gives me, she gives us five worksheets to complete.
Yeah, yeah, then when she said very well.
What?
Yeah, and like, then like.
Okay, done or not, this one?
Like,
she goes to finish. Yeah, done already. A is done. B. Wow. Well, you're chit-chatting about your daily lives. We need to finish all the questions. Oh. B.
I
yeah, I must copy down. Will you copy down?
I'm copying down.
Yeah, copy down. Okay, find his average speed for the whole journey. So how to find average speed?
1.22 km or 12.2.
There's no like point, ma.
So 1.22?
Yeah, 1.22. What?
Your
no. So what's the average speed for the whole journey? How to find speed?
Equals
distance divided by time.
Oh my god, I actually remember for this one.
So time. So what's the total distance traveled? 1.22. What's the total time taken? Total time is 1 1/5 and 24 minutes, right? So it's 24. You need to change all to hours. Plus 1 and 1/5.
1.22 km.
Yeah.
Oh.
That's part A. No, part B, average speed, total distance.
I find it like the worst topic you will ever learn.
No, then you like school. I already learned all topics.
Really?
Yeah. Then I learned algebra.
Whoa. 1, 2, 3. We get 76.25.
You know, like, the kinetic and potential thing. I suck at it.
Okay, okay. Adult. 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 A lot of thoughts coming to your mind, okay?
You learn people,
why? Wait.
Because my
teacher.
Adult.
This is speed. Kilometers per hour. Adult. Keep your thoughts inside for a while, okay?
I already write
down. What? Yeah, do it, yeah. Okay, next one. I printed the ACS paper so you can try, okay?
Wait, does it have this topic?
Yes, everything.
Is it
oh?
Is it paper?
No, it's a mid-year paper.
Does it have this?
I did
see one yesterday and then
why questions
come out?
Skip.
Is algebra fraction difficult to explain?
Yes. Next one. Okay, 28. So a car took A car took 4 hours to travel from A to B. Oh, A to B.
An average speed of
17. So S equals to 7. 5 hours. So 5 hours, the time is 5 hours. S. Yeah. So what's the average? Oh, wait.
I got
56 km. Yeah, a bus took 5 hours to travel the same distance. Wait, okay, so we have a car and a bus. They are two different things, okay? So the car took 4 hours only. Wait, the car took 4 hours. That means what's the distance? Yeah, the distance is 280. So if I want to find the speed of the bus, 280 divided by 5. What? 56 kilometers per hour, okay?
Huh?
Yeah. Done.
It's a two-step.
Because the bus took 5 hours, but the car only took 4 hours.
It's gonna be the topic that I really don't understand. It's like they teach us the method.
It's just DSC triangle.
No, but like in practice, even an exam, they make
you
think so much.
Like, yeah.
Who is this?
Then you see the
answer.
You see the
answer,
like,
Huang
Ran.
Oh,
you use a Chinese idiom.
Huang Ran.
Huang
Ran. Spelling this. I won't spell my Chinese.
Wait, do you know how to?
So
okay, okay, okay. 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 Hello. Okay, Adel, you're talking about everything except math, you know. We can do math, right? Wait, do you know how to Wait, who knows how to write Huang Ran Da Wu? All of a sudden, really, you don't know how to write?
I'll write it for you, like, to write.
Really, yeah? I don't know how to write now. Huang, I know how to write, see? Huang.
No, that's why you pinyin.
Da.
I read finish already.
Oh my god, all your Chinese is powerful, man. Is it correct? Is that correct?
Yes, correct.
You know how to write also?
It's so easy!
Serious?
I don't
memorize
the name, I memorize the name. Can
you jump
like that?
Okay. Okay, next one. Question 29.
It's like...
Oh, what? I don't know.
Okay, tau A and B. Okay, back to math again, alright? So A, but so far you're like enjoying this chapter?
No.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. No. No. Yes. No. Half. Half. Right.
The worst topic of my life.
Wait. Now
no,
why?
Wait.
So do you realize they always ask the same thing? It's always DST. Then they'll give you two things. You find the third one.
Like it.
No, it's always the same. You understand? Like
yeah,
I give you
so
D. What? No, okay, let's just see another example. See, question 29. Distance is what? 560. Let's write down 560. Okay, D is 560. Mr. Lin left out. Okay. KM, huh? Nice or not?
No,
that can't.
No, where
are you? You can't please her.
What? Yeah, I know how to please her. Give her.
Like
give her a smiley face, see? Eh? Right. Okay. Mr.
Oh
Lin. Wait, so Mr. Lin left town A at 8 o'clock. Okay, Mr. Lin left at 8 a.m. Travel towards B at an average speed of 70. So S equals to 70. Mr. Who left town B? So Mr. Who is here? H.
Mr. Who?
Mr. Who has long hair one, huh? Right?
Why
long hair?
Okay.
What? Oh my god, it's a Mr. Mouse.
8:30. Wait, so he left. This hair lah. His hair. So he left at 8:30. So, Mr. This is kilometers.
Is there a girl now?
Wait. You're disturbing my thoughts. I can't read properly. Because I have to answer your questions, right? Now, see, I need to read from the beginning again. Mr. Who left town with the visitor? Okay, towards A. So, who is going here? And Lin is going here. Right? Every spot 84. So, this traveling at 84, S equal to 84. Well done.
Wait, what is the answer?
What?
Oh,
haven't yet.
Oh.
Wait, what's the question? At what time did Mr. Who reach town A, huh?
The question is at town B at 4.
Yeah,
reach about
4 p.m. Huh? What are you
talking
about?
He reached town A at
4 p.m. 4 p.m., how do you know? Because you see, we have distance and speed, right? So what's the time? Oh man, the drawing too big already,
right? Your S looks like
560 divided by 84, right? Equals to 6 and 2/3. What? 6 2/3. So 6 2/3 hour, right? So Mr. Who traveled for 6 2/3 hour. He started.
The
56.84 thing. Okay. Alright, so from 8:30, travel for 6 hours.
Two over three.
From 8:30, right? You travel for 6 2/3 hours. What time will he reach here? 2 hours is how many minutes?
2 hours, 2 hours, 40 minutes.
40 minutes. Well done. 2 hours and
60 divided by 3
then
times 2.
It's only the ELB.
Wait. I'm showing
eight.
6 hours, sorry. 6 hours and 40 minutes. So from here, what time will you reach here? 6 hours later, it'll be 2 p.m., right?
Yeah.
Then plus another 40 minutes will be 3:10. Wow, see how you look so clever after eating all the pineapple tarts, right?
No, I only ate fish.
Okay, okay. After eating all the fish, you all became clever. What? Not in hours. No, this is Mr. Lin. They asked Mr. Who?
Oh, you asked for who?
You took Mr. Lin.
I only ate the salmon and the vegetables. I didn't like
Okay, okay, okay. Now is the difficult one. How far was Mr. Lin when Mr. Who reached town 8?
Wait, it's only AY. Oh my god, I thought you solved that, I think. My pink can
How far was Mr. Lin when he reached town 8? So what we want to do is we take 70 times 6 2/3.
To bring like the
figure. We give you full
scan. No, like the thing, right? Then one page, like the math book. Then one page is one question, like that, but you have space.
We give you full scan.
The one not attached to the paper.
I can't remember
confused. Where's the A working?
Where's
the A?
Yeah. A is
the only. Then
what's
all good? What's
what? Which part?
Yeah.
This is just to show me what the story is about.
Wait, it's 4, 6, 6, 2/3.
Yeah. Oh, no, this is part B.
Is that the answer?
No.
Oh, it's not the answer?
The answer is you gotta take 5, 6, 0 minus.
Minus 4, 6, 6.
And 2/3. How many marks is this? This is 5 marks question.
Thanks so much.
Yeah.
What's the answer?
93 1/3. Alright, this part B.
Is that the answer?
Yeah.
Okay.
Part A here, part B here. Actually, quite simple. I see only 2 steps. Oh. 2 steps done.
Joy,
are you okay? Why are you not writing anything? Why are you staring at the...
Well,
you're just staring at the face.
I'm staring.
It's a smiley face.
I wrote everything down, but it went all the way.
93 1/3 is my answer. Now, see, at this point of time, I'm not so worried, you know. I won't be like, everyone must know how to do. Why? Because it's still February, okay? We still have a bit of time.
Yes.
And this is the first time
you're
looking
at...
It's the first time you're looking at speed, or rather the second time, right? It will take a while, you understand? For your brain to grow to light speed, it will take a while. Just like
no,
how
my brain will never grow.
No, just like it took them 2 weeks for the plant to grow. It takes a while. You understand?
Where's the baby turtle? Where's the shrimp?
The shrimp is inside.
Oh,
the shrimp.
Shrimp
is inside.
You want to give us the turtle?
Yeah, sure.
No. Don't put the turtle first, okay?
I have air inside
the. Okay, next. Is it the last one?
Yes.
The last one. Okay, car travels from F to G. See, they give you a different story. It's somewhere inside.
What color
is the screen? Yeah, it's very tiny. There's a blue one, there's a transparent one, there's a white and red one, there's a red one.
You can
dry it, right? And then you can eat it. Sun dry.
Okay, so let's look at the last one, right? So the car travels at average speed of 70, a motorcycle from G. So C for a car. Okay, I'll draw a car.
I hope there's enough space for this question.
Yeah, there's plenty of space, right?
No, there's not plenty of space.
Okay, I'm not gonna draw a car.
See? Car. And motorcycle. What?
Yeah, please don't draw the motorcycle is a bicycle.
No, you draw a motorcycle.
How to draw?
Yeah, you should invite her to the front to draw. Okay. I don't know if you draw. There's a bicycle!
There's no pedal, hello.
It doesn't even hello, there's a pedal. There's no seat or something. And the bicycle is just a car.
Okay, let me think. Okay. Oops.
What is that? That's even worse.
Don't worry. What the?
No, then you just draw
it.
No, I draw
it. How do you look
like? No, you draw like a curve.
No.
Body, right? Do you?
This is like a skateboard with a bicycle.
bicycle.
That's like how you ride on the snow.
Yeah. Okay, wait. Both vehicles start their journey at the same time and meet each other. So they met somewhere here. After traveling for 4 hours, they find a distance. Wow, this is my favorite question. Because it's only one step. It's only one step, okay? How to do that? Just take 70 plus 80 times. Times 4 times 4.5. Equals to?
You say there's enough space, so let's see.
150 times 4.5.
Because the last question is 70
plus 80. Okay, 75. Yeah, wait on. Okay, final answer, that's all.
Huh?
Now, these two vehicles are traveling towards each other. They're traveling, they're not crash, right? They're just traveling towards each other and they met over here. So you need to add both of their speed because they are traveling towards each other. They are covering the distance at the same time. They're moving at the same time, you understand? Moving at the same time, you must add the speed. What?
A lot of homework for school.
Can I write this paper,
please? Wait. So question 30, right, is one of the three types of special speed question. One more time. Let me just say one more time. Question 30 is one of the three types. Now, there are three types of special speed question. Now, the usual one, of course, is DSC. Everybody knows, right? But then there's this type. This type is when they're traveling towards each other. Another one is catching up. Catching up, that means one comes like that, and then another one is like catching up. That's the second type. Yeah, one is like this, then the other one is catching up, right? Yeah, and then there's another one that's moving apart one. Okay, so got three special types, right? So I'm not going to the special types yet. We just do the simple one first. Okay, and we're done. Huh? No, don't worry, the special type we'll do it later, you know? Once you're better.
I still
can't find the YouTube stuff. Is this section C or section B? B and C. Okay, this is the ACS picture. Section B and C. So let's take a look at that. You all can start to do now. You can use the calculator. Or rather, you have to use the calculator. You have to use the calculator, okay? Let me load the paper now.
I did a lot of
missing questions. Okay, fine. I'll take a look.
How do you print so many worksheets? What are like the middle ones?
Like, they have more than one printer,
I'm guessing. No, I want to record the screen. Okay, let's go through this. The average scores of A, B, C, D was 86. Now, if the average is 86, 4%, what's the total? What happened to my pen? What's the total? 86 times 4, right? Which is 344. So 344 is the total. Now you add another person, Edward. So the average you get 74. So 74 times 5. 370, right? So you want to find Edward's score?
I thought 86 was the total of everyone.
Oh, no.
26.
It's not.
You failed math.
You failed math.
So I failed badly, okay?
Oh no.
26.
I failed.
Got it. Okay, wait. Got it. Everyone, okay? Is everybody okay with this?
Yes, but wait. Let me copy now. Yeah.
It's not that hard.
Okay.
Shh. Let me copy.
Yes. We are letting you copy.
I think okay. I'm done copying.
Okay. Next.
I got 4.
So 2 marks for this, right? Next. Okay, the mass of a papaya is 2.4 kilograms. The mass of durian is 2/3 the mass. What is the total mass of both the papaya and the durian? One step, right? Times 1 2/3. Yeah. One whole is the papaya, 2/3 is the durian, right?
1.6.
4. Huh? 4. Answer is 4 kilograms.
It's like one step.
They want the total mass. So it's 4.
I did this.
No, you do 2 sets. 2 sets is fine. 2 sets is fine.
3 sets.
3 sets is fine. Do you get 4 kilograms?
Yeah.
That's fine. Okay. Any question for this? No. Good.
Okay, I got south for the next one.
Okay, the the square grid shows the plan of a playroom. In what direction are the tables from the toys? The table from the toys.
South.
Okay. First one is south.
Then I put the table
below the toys. This is south. So a new fish tank will be placed in the playroom location southeast of the stool. So the stool southeast is here. It's southeast, okay? And northeast of the books. What?
Down one more
breath. Northeast. So northeast of the books. Wait, let me clear this first. Where's the northeast of the book? North.
Below the toys, yeah.
East. Right. So, yeah, you connect X marks the spot. You see? It's here. Okay, don't take here. Take here, okay? Take here. Got it? I mean, ignore all this, right? So basically, just put a take here. Hello, you have a lot of complaints, no? This one is tough. Anyone got this?
Yeah.
What do you get?
10.
Okay, you can use guess and check if you want, right? Usually this, what do you get? Haven't reached it.
56.
86? 56. Why so much? Anybody else? Anybody else?
I got
0. You got 0? How can it be 0?
I only write these two things.
Why? 70
I wrote these two things that I read the question and I give up.
Wait, she bought. How come? Okay, wait, let's check, okay? This is not easy, you know? This is actually quite tough.
It's a little easy
tough. So, wait, so pens, 70 cents each. So, we do not know how many pens, but we know that she bought 8 more rulers than pens, right? So, pen. So, 0.7 times T is the total cost of pens. Okay, 70 cents times P. P is the number of pens. Then how about rulers? Maybe bought 8 more rulers. So 50 cents times the number of pens plus 8 more. Right, is the cost of rulers. Okay, so this is the cost of rulers, this is the cost of pen. So she spent $1.40 more on pen than rulers. So if I take this minus this, I'm gonna get $1.40. Okay, so it looks like that. Or if I were to take, okay, see, if I multiply in, what do I get? I actually get 0.5 10 plus 4. All right, that's the number of rulers, the cost of the rulers. So what's the difference again? Because 0.5 of this, 0.5 times P, 0.5 times 8. 0.5 of 8 is 4. All right, so the difference between these two, is... zero. So if I take this minus this, so 0.2 P equals to $1.40 plus $4. So the number of pen is equal to calculator. Wait, ah. No, 0.2 P is $5.40. I want P. P is the number of pen. Wait, 5.4 divided by 0.2. 27. So number of pen is 27, but they want rulers, huh? So you need to take 27 plus 8 equals to 35. So I rank this as one of the hardest questions here because I am not using normal method to solve. Okay. I'm not using a normal method, right? I'm using the algebra method to solve this.
Yes,
I said it's 35.
I don't understand.
it's okay. So these type of questions, once again, it's going to take a while, right? It won't be like within 10 minutes I explain, oh, then immediately you understand. No, that's not going to happen, okay? It'll take a while. Now, some of you might go back and then you look at this again, and then eventually you know how to do. That's great. Maybe you take 2 months, right? And then finally I understood how it works.
Do you only
have
time to go through more questions?
You should have time. No, it's still have time. Now, this is easy.
I couldn't be bothered, so I just did like
6. I think it's 6.
6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 times 4 plus 4 plus 4.
6 times 4 equals 24.
4 times 4 is 16.
Okay,
so the length here is 24. The length here is 16, right? So the answer is just 24 times 16 divided by 2.
2. 192.
Yeah, that's all. Now, how come it works? Is because you look at this, right? This bit, I call this one. This one is the same as this one, right? Then this one is the same as this one. This one is the same as this one. This one is the same as this one.
So
they're all half. It's just half.
I was finding one triangle.
You don't have to find a triangle, right? It's just half, alright? Because they can be replaced. Like you can put this one here, this one there. Done.
This one is a lot of fraction paper.
Next. Okay, so here's slightly more difficult. Express the length of the remaining wire in terms of W. So the original length was 150 cm, and then you make this Gabriel, made this thing. How many W is this? 16. So 16 W is used to make this. So remaining length will be just 150. Minus 16 W.
For my answer, I put bracket 150 minus 16 W bracket and
meter. This cm. Centimeter.
The 3 mil my house.
3 mil? What 3 mil?
The 3 mil my house fell.
Okay.
Okay,
wait.
I'm so scared that I
have
to use the block wire.
Okay, next one. Now B, Gabriel used the remaining wire to form an equilateral triangle. So if W equals to 6, I don't know, 150 minus 16 times of W, which is 6, then you divide by 3.
Okay?
18.
Okay. Very good. Thanks. Whoa.
I got 1, 2, 3, and then
24, 38, 12, 22. Wait. What's the ratio of the number of pupils who chose apple to the total number of choose durian, mango? Wait. Okay, what's apple? Apple here is
34.
Okay. Wait. So durian, how many is this? 38, right?
24
to bracket 38
plus 12
plus 22
equals
1 to 3. Yeah.
What
do you get? Last one?
1 to 3.
1 is 3.
Okay.
Then another one up there is.
Then I got
32.
Yeah. Okay.
Because 3 quarters
is 96.
I agree. Next one. 240. What?
Which one?
Let's look at 8, okay? Board B is 270 cm long. What is the length of board A? Wait first. So the whole thing is 270. Now how many gaps are there?
6.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Try the questions.
Yeah, I let you try already, but you spend the time talking. That's a problem.
So divide by 6.
Okay, what's 270 divided by 6?
45.
45. So one of the gaps is 45, right? So how many gaps are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we take 45 times 4.
180.
Yeah, wait. I know you're thinking faster than I can write. 180. So that means this gap here is 180 from here to here.
And then one gap is
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 gaps. So 180 divided by 6 equals to 30. And how many gaps are there?
Eight.
So 30 times 8.
240.
Yeah. So easy. So easy. 30 times 8 equals to 240. Okay, so that is the length of what it. Okay, ran out of time. So we managed to do how many? 8 questions. Not bad. Wow.
Question
9, please. 15 minutes. Wow, this is a sweet question. Yeah. Okay, Lincoln, Wendy started jogging on the same floor.
They understand.
Okay, so this is the second type that I'm talking about, right? It's the catching up one. Okay, one person catching up with another person. Okay, now I'm going to take about 15 minutes to explain this, so I'm not going to talk about this today. Alright? Now, this one takes a long time. Okay? So please keep this paper. I don't have homework because you all have tests, right? So
another question to
practice
paper, please.
Wait. Okay, can you all keep this paper? Now, if you have the time, go back and finish this one. If you have time, go ahead and finish this one. Next week, we will go through the rest of this. And then we'll do a few more practice paper, right? Because I think we are very fast, you know, in terms of the syllabus. So I may want to...
Especially section C questions.
So I may want to go into some heuristic problem sum. Problem sum.
I wanted to come for like, the problem yeah. That he goes for, but my mom said
it's okay. Right, so that's all for today. Okay, see you next week. Please bring this paper, Ethel. Remember to bring, I've been printing everywhere, you know. Ethel. Ethel. Remember to bring, okay? Okay.